The Destiny universe is at a continual state of chaos. Since the beginning, we've been given information, and before we even have time for a follow-up, we moved halfway across the galaxy to deal with a new looming threat. So I would like to slow down the spaceship and really focus in on certain unsolved mysteries, TM, regarding characters and events in Destiny. For this first one, we'll be talking about our future space ruler and resident full-time party haver, Kallus. More specifically, his true current appearance. And before I continue, I just want to say we'll be going through History Channel standards, so most of this will be completely unsubstantiated and or biased based on misunderstanding the lore. The biggest twist of Destiny 2's launch wasn't us killing Gaul during the campaign. It wasn't even us getting our life back after a 10-minute excursion to the EDZ. For me personally, it was having an in-lore reason for why we continue to kill raid bosses week after week, obviously not counting Atheons. The big twist at the end of the Leviathan raid, spoilers, was that we fought a robot version of Kallus during the final encounter. This revelation led to people questioning if we even met the real Kallus, and if he actually looked like how he does in the raid. Now the obvious answer to that is that this is his real appearance, just in robotic form. This could be believable just based on how other notable Cabal look in the game and lore. Look at Gull, Kor, Spire Star's boss, Keitel, Kallus' daughter, and even our boy Mr. Tarek. They all share similar features to the Kallus bot, aka large bipedal space walruses. But to follow up on the original question, sure Kallus may have looked at that before, but what does he look like now? And why would he even need a robot fake of himself? We learned from the It's Aired Back lore tab, and the Chronicon, that when the Leviathan was seemingly stuck in a place far out of space and time, Kallus went out to greet something, and ended up staring into the deep. Now this could mean a few things. Either Kallus is telling the truth, and when he donned that pressure gel suit and went out to meet the quote, destination of his banishment in private, he alone truly saw the darkness. This is kind of hard to believe based on what one of Kallus' scribes said after he returned. Basically, they said that the pressure suit was punctured and that he was out there for up to 12 hours. And I mean, a lot of things can happen after floating in nothingness for 12 hours. The only thing keeping the story semi-straight is the fact that the symptoms of this meeting, aka tremors and intense pressure focus on their heads/minds, felt by everyone in the Leviathan, also matches other run-ins with the darkness by more trustworthy sources, aka Exodus Green. I know I went off on a bit of a tangent there, but the other outcome is Kallus just straight up fucking died. Kinda went a little hard there, but what I mean by this is Kallus damaged himself physically and mentally while floating in the void. In the incapacitated headspace, he would need a new visage to 1. Keep his loyalists feeling secure in their dear leader, and 2. For meetings with other species that he thinks are lesser to him but the strongest of their kind. That new visage, I believe, is the robot body. Now being the lore fence sitter that I am, I believe a little bit of column A and a little bit of column B. I believe Kallus did meet the darkness in that void, but while communicating with them, he punctured a suit and damaged himself. On a little side note here, maybe the darkness purposely punctured a suit to make the story less believable? I believe this is why the robot is how we first meet Kallus. His people created it as a way to help him survive. This theory that Kallus is either dead or way too far gone that it needs extra help, works with two of the most prominent theories in the Destiny community currently. The first one is that Kallus is the nightmare head we see during the raid, and the other one is Kallus is the engine / connected to the Leviathan tech and doesn't have a true body anymore. Both of these options imply the fact that he is no longer Cabal, which I definitely agree with. Starting with the Kit Leviathan theory, we see evidence of this in the lore tab of the Penumbral Cloak. The Drifter straight up says, quote, "The Cabal Emperor isn't even Cabal anymore, right?" This, along with the distinctly robotic way Kallus describes him examining his surroundings, analyze every fiber of this being, data from his spectral analysis of the Drifter, leads me to believe that Kallus is fully converted. And you could be saying, wait, couldn't the Drifter just be talking to one of the robots we fight in the raid? And sure, there's a reason to believe that. In the same cloak tab, Kallus replies back to the Drifter, asking if it's a real him by saying, yes, one of me. And we know that the only clone of Kallus we've ever seen are the robots. But the thing that ruins this theory for me is how this Kallus bot is described. It's described as being a giant being, big enough that the Drifter needed to sparrow up to him to even be at hearing range for Kallus. Kallus also mentions that he hasn't entertained an audience so directly in centuries, which to me means that it couldn't have been the raid bot, as just 1 year ago at that time we stormed the throne for the first time and took him out. Another interesting tidbit that adds to this theory is the fact that whenever we hear Kallus talk, it always sounds completely clear. I don't just mean when we come face to face to him, but also during the entire raid, the menagerie, and even when he's talking through Werner 99. There is zero static, it's clear as day. It's almost like he's actually there with us during all the encounters. This seems to be the most agreed upon theory out of the two most popular, based on my research, but for posterity, I would like to bring up the Nightmare Kallus theory. So this theory has arguably been around longer in the community than the Head in the Jar Kallus. Sadly though, it doesn't have the backing that Kallus in the Jar does. So the Nightmare Realm could be easily connected to the earlier story of Kallus' journey into the Deep, since it was created by the Scion Feltrock who had a seat on Kallus' Scion Council before passing. If Kallus met with the ultimate end, he would probably be pretty self-conscious about being able to live long enough to experience it himself. He also probably significantly shortened his chances to make it that far by puncturing his suit in deep space. Both of these cases could lead to Kallus ascending into the gaping mouth we see in the raid. This ascension being out of our normal realm would allow him to guarantee himself being the last to witness the universe ending, since he doesn't really have to deal with outside forces. But that's about as far as I could get. The problems for this theory pop up faster than your guardian after a sonic blast hits you in the raid. You see, this space was used as a prison for betrayers of the Royal Emperor. Refer to the Vest of Feltrock for more info on that. And that kind of seems like a weird place to store my ethereal body if I was looking to outlive the universe. Especially if that realm was supposed to hold prisoners of invasions and war. Now sadly, I've personally never been an emperor, so I don't know the rules and lifestyles of one, but I don't think having your consciousness that close to your enemies would be a great idea. However, one piece of evidence that has been staring us in the face since 2018 gives me hope for the Nightmare Callus theory. So in 2018, Bungie released a seasonal event called Festival of the Lost. In this event, we were given masks that replicate main characters and enemies in the Destiny universe. We had a Drifter mask, we had an Aldrin mask, and of course we had a Callus one. But what was so special about this mask? It was the Nightmare Realm Callus, not the normal one. The implication of this choice by Bungie is that either internally or in-game, Callus is the Nightmare Realm head. Sure, they could have chosen the most scary face for that mask, as a giant yellow slug mask wouldn't and doesn't hit as hard. But to me, this implies that at least a part of the Nightmare head is a real Callus, and this is where we go off the rails for a second. I believe that both theories are correct in tandem. I think the head is his consciousness, but he goes between the Nightmare Realm and technology to communicate with us and the people of Sol. This would mean that Callus doesn't spend time in his mind prison, but instead uses it as a sort of freeway to other technology that he takes over. This would also work with the Nine Dust that spread around the Leviathan, Dust Lore Book Entry Number 5. If he's jumping his consciousness through dimensions freely, that would definitely attract the attention of the Nine in my opinion. And even the conversation he had with the Drifter isn't safe from this mega theory. Callus responds to asking if it was really him by saying, "Yes, one of me." Now most people took this to mean he was talking to Callus bots from the raid, but what if it was implying that Callus was split between all of his electronic Kali? That's the plural of Callus. So he really was talking to just one of him. Now I will fully admit, I haven't researched into this theory as deeply as the other two, since it's kinda semi-organic for my trash brain, and I'm sure more lore-acquainted people can poke a ton of holes in this, but I thought I might as well throw this out before Callus takes a trip to the Destiny Content Vault next week. Although we may never know what happened to the Cabal Emperor during his fateful exile, or what truly lies deep within the Leviathan above Nessus' orbit, we can only keep ourselves and the city safe by donning our spinfoil hats and asking the questions the Vanguard won't. This is Mr. Punquist from Everyone Bound, signing out. I will see you guys next time.